This had to make these potatoes, which are called fulmine. Basically, what it is, it's a big pain in the neck, but it's beside the point. I went home, I went to 99 cents, I got a whole 10 pound bag of potatoes, and that's all I did the whole afternoon, and I got it. I went through a lot of potatoes, but I eventually got it. So this is also...
Did you afford a little potatoes to do this morning?
Yeah, that's basically what I did.
I'll show you how to do it a little later. Just so you know, now, Tourne is spelled T-O-U-R-N-E, an accent on the
And it means churn. And
T-O-U-R-N-E.
Here's a little one. We'll do it. I'll show it because it takes
two seconds. A live demonstration of a Tourne.
I haven't done them in a while, but I'll try, okay? I'll try. You're not filming this. This is not filmable stuff. Okay, so it has to have seven sides. So usually what I do is I just cut. I'll make a big that's... Then you have to... You have to take in. Here, just... When you peel potatoes, always put them in water. right away, cold water. And you always start cooking potatoes with cold water.
Tomatoes on sale.
Yes, here, they're on sale. £2 for 99 cents. Anyway, bottom line is you just look at these, circle what is on sale, okay? Then you can choose your protein, then you choose your veggies and your starches. Fruits for dessert, or fruits that you, where you make desserts. For example, instead of just eating strawberries like this, the strawberries here at Sprouts are 98 cents per pound, which is a really good price. What can you do with that? Well, if you have some mint in your garden, and I'm sure you have a lemon, and you have a little bit of sugar, then make a bowl, slice your, you know, wash your strawberries, dry them, take the little green part out, the stem, cut them in half or in quarters, depending on the size, put them in a big bowl, put some lemon juice, a little sugar, and some chopped up mint, and it's delicious. Wait an hour and there it is. And if you have leftover, if you made too much and you have leftover, you can make smoothies or you can make sorbet, you can make a lot of different things, okay? So this is basically, how to budget, how to make your menu. You know, it depends, obviously, if you have books, it helps, or you can go, there are a lot of things online where you can go and type in chicken and chicken recipes, and you have, I mean, it's endless, the number of chicken recipes. It's other people's food in the restaurants. But when you're cooking, you know, you can't always invite everybody out to the restaurant, so invite them to your home. So you can, in this case, you can, it's going to be a lot cheaper because you're going to buy the product and make it healthy, right? It's also, in a lot of ways, healthier. It's a lot healthier for you because then you know what you're putting in exactly in your food. I'm gonna kind of, right here, I'm skipping one part because I'm going into the prep, which I didn't put in here. So.
You wanna write that down?
Huh?
You said you didn't put it in?
Yes, I'm gonna go into prepping in before the anatomy of a chicken.
Okay, so.
So,
write that in
because. There. Just put prepping of ingredients for roast chicken for now. And then I'll alter it and send it to you. So, there's one thing. I might include or not, depends. So this is the prep part. When you buy herbs, okay? Most people grab the stem and throw them like this. Never do that. You don't want it to go down here. There's moisture. You want to keep them like this, okay? Also, because if you're putting them in the refrigerator for a day or two, it's better that they, you know, they're still covered, but they, you know, won't be in the moisture. So first thing you should do, or that I do, which I find quite necessary, because you can keep them longer that way. You have a whole bunch of parsley. Just cut off the stems here, make it all nice and plush. Not too much water. You don't need a lot, just throw them in there, okay? And that way it'll keep nice and moist. You cover them. Cover them if you want to put them in the fridge or leave them like this. Alright. Same thing. So what you want to do at the beginning is that you want to have your mise en place. Mise en place means to put into place. So your mise en place are going to be all the ingredients that you're going to use for each part of of the meal that you're preparing. So if it's for chicken, if you're going to make stuffed chicken, for example, stuffed roasted chicken, then you're going to have some thyme, fresh thyme, a little parsley, garlic, and what you can do is put some onions and carrots on the side. It gives good flavor to the chicken, okay? Because the chicken's going to give out sauce. So what you want is that sauce to be tasty. And celery. Now, I know we have the celery. Way to make pumpkin puree that's very tasty. and not just the regular old mashed potatoes. But in the meantime, we are going to put this onion. Of course, this doesn't have to be finely chopped. You can separate them by doing this. They have to go on the side, okay? At the same time, while you're doing this, we're going to prepare the milk. You always want to clear your, before you start cutting, you always want to clear your cutting board. Make sure it's nice and clean. So you're doing onions, you know, one onion, but you're doing it, actually this I shouldn't have done at the end, but it's okay. So you're going to have, and these you're going to make slivers. Bill's knives are much better. I bought this one. This not very good.
Where did he put his little knives?
Oh, I don't know. Did he want mine? So, the slivers like this. Okay. Then you're going to have a bit of a leftover onion there. We'll see if you can put more or not. Okay, then we have the carrots, which we're going to peel. What did you do with all those carrots? Oh. Who's going to use this for anything?
I don't think I can use them.
Oh, okay. All right, so put some carrots in here. Sugar factor that they caramelizes, and that gives another taste, an additional taste. So, and any vegetable, for example, onions have sugar in them, carrots have sugar, they all have sugar, but some have more than others. We're going to put in some. inside the chicken.
Middle,
it's basically you've got it going. This is for your milk. This is for the inside of your chicken. Okay. This is what I'm gonna eat. This is for your chicken. And now we're gonna work on the chicken. Oh, there's another thing called herbes de Provence, which are very, very good. It's a mixture of herbs. It was quote unquote invented in the south of France. You can also use on chicken.
You'll see that in a lot of TV shows, Herbes de Provence, H-E-R-B-S, de Provence, like province, right?
Yeah, Provence is actually a province. Okay, so, of France. Alright, done with that. Left over. And what you want to do when you're not using, when you're not working with something, just put everything over there, that way it's all nice and light. And you know where it is. Okay?
Constantly be organized.
And clean up. For example, time, it does make a mess.
Do you notice Chef Ann's using cutting mats rather than a cutting board? Right? Those are portable. Do you want a cutting board?
I have some. At home, I use, I'm waiting for a call from my daughter, that's why. Cutting boards. Okay, I use, it's a personal preference. I use the bamboo cutting boards. I find them to be very practical. They clean well, contrary to wood that kind of goes in. Plastic ones, they stain, I don't like it. It's really a person. But these, because I travel, then this is a lot easier than if I have to carry, you know, some big old cutting board, which I sometimes do depending on what I'm cooking. Okay, so we have the onions, the celery, and the carrots. What is this called? It doesn't matter if you mispronounce it. Mirepoix. Mirepoix.
And
what is it used for? It's for flavoring. Initially, it's for flavoring. So you use this as a base to give meats flavor or soups or anything like that. Whenever I make soup, I always have mirepoix. Unless I'm making a white soup, and then in that case, I would be using parsnips because they're white, because you don't want color. You can still use the celery, you can still use the onion, but this is going to give color to your white soup, so you're not using parsnips instead. Okay? All right, and I said we don't peel the garlic because while we're roasting, okay, so this is basically good to go. Now we can start working on the chicken. Put over here a little bit of our salt. Oh, I have the milk. Thank you.
No, it'll be finished.
Is this your favorite here? Where would they be standing?
They can come.
They can come.
Just to take a look for a few minutes.
So this is the, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
This is Miss Gabby.
Hi, hello,
this
Gabby.
Chef,
how are you?
Chef Natalie, yes. Chef Ann.
Okay, so I'll
make
them in about
5 minutes. Okay, is it okay we take a picture with them?
Yes, it should be fine.
You need permission?
Yeah, only one of them is no picture list, but the rest are good.
Okay.
So, okay, thank you.
You're good. We'll take a good picture.
All right. Okay, so we've got our mise en place here. Okay, garlic, peeled garlic, fresh thyme. The reason we use fresh thyme is a lot more. And cake. All right. And we are going to be using some parsley. We're putting that there. And all right. Actually, if they had a really, really big cutting board, that'd be better.
There's.
Yeah.
Kids come in, this is clearly the market. Okay, take a pictures. So they're called the chef case thing.
Okay.
But the kids are on this orange shirt.
Alright, no problem. Just changing gloves. Okay. So now we've got here a farm fresh chicken. Says whole fryer, but basically it's a roasting chicken. You always want to wear gloves when you're dealing with protein.
In our classes, they wear gloves regardless.
So. Okay, I'm doing the chicken, unwrapping it, it's probably going to have some juices. Good idea to put some paper towel down. I just continue, right? When they come in, I don't stop.
Yeah.
So, I'll do the chicken. So, here we have a 4.825 chicken, okay? And it is at $1.69.
You come around the table. Okay. You guys can come around the table, but you're not touching anything. You're not touching anything. But
you're taking this basic part of the wood, okay, and then you're gonna cut here. Okay. So this is called the cavity of the chicken outside. And the thing about why we learn how to cook a chicken before any other fowls or birds are because the chicken is the easiest one and the one that you probably use the most. Okay? So when you're stuffing a chicken, just like in Thanksgiving with a turkey, this is the cavity and this is where you put all the stuffing. Okay? Now, as I mentioned before, really important part, you do have the skin, okay, that is edible and that you can use to do a lot of different things. You have the flesh, the meat, and then you have the bones, which you also use. So you have three items here that you will be using, and two are edible, but the third one you're going to use to make stock and or broth. Broth, difference between broth and stock is broth, you take raw bones and or also cook bones and you put them in a pot with cold water and mirepoix and herbs, and that will make your broth. The stock is when you brown the bones first and then you put them in cold water with the mirepoix and cook it together. Okay? So there you have it. Your chicken. And you want to always dab it dry a little bit. It's easier to work. You saw when I cook it and it wasn't dry, so it was a little more difficult. I'm sorry? Why am I making chicken? Because this is a class on how to make chicken, how to fabricate chicken. And fabrication is basically the breakdown of a whole chicken. So, you know, when your mom goes to the supermarket, she buys chicken breasts or chicken legs or chicken quarters. Then what does she do? She cooks it at home, right?
And she eats it.
Well, I hope so.
She eats all of it. I get nothing.
So the different parts of the chicken, you'll be cooking different ways for different recipes. And then you have the dark meat and the white meat. Okay, so the breast is considered the white meat. These are the on top here. And then this is dark meat, wings included, by the way. Even though it's closer to the breast, it's still considered as dark meat. Okay, so the head's not here. Got them taken off. But some chickens do come with everything on them. They still have the feet on them, and they have the head. You can buy the whole thing. And in downtown, Chinese market, actually, in Chinatown, you can buy ducks with everything on it. You know, so some of them, I've heard, this I haven't seen, but I heard some even have the feathers on them. But you don't cook them with the feathers. So this, I'm going to take this back.
Thank you.
So let's take our picture. Well, before she starts that chicken, if you guys want to, we'll go over here. Yeah. All right. So let's line up in two or three rows.
Okay.
The breasts go down. You usually put them up in a in the pan, but the chicken walks like this. These are its legs. These are the wings. Neck is here. Here's its tail. And the chicken has two kinds of meats. One is the white meat, and one is the dark meat. The white meat is the breast, and the dark meat are the two legs and the two wings. So you use the skin, you have the skin of the chicken which wraps all the way around it. Then you have the flesh, and then you have the bones. And what you do is that you're gonna use everything. The skin you can use to make galantine or ballotine, which basically you debone the meat, and you can stuff it with different things, and then you wrap it in the skin, and then you wrap it in cheesecloth, and then you can either roast it or you boil it in some savory stock, okay? But we're not gonna do that. So the first thing you're going to do is you're gonna look at your chicken and you're gonna feel inside and outside. You have the wraps, what do you call it again?
The spine,
of course, the tail, the neck. And then you have to know your chicken. So just, fiddle with it, look at it, okay, these are the legs, breast, wings, and you have to know your meats, you have to know your animal. So the first thing you're going to do, and we're going to stretch out the legs a little like this, okay, is we're going to pull back. These are the wings, you're going to pull them back. In other words, this is the inside of the wing, you're going to pull it towards the exterior. See, it's a lot easier when it's cutting. And then you're going to cut these wings off. The reason you do that, first of all, you don't need this part, but you're going to keep it. You're not going to throw it away, you're going to keep it because this is going to go in here. And it's also going to give taste. So again, take this, pull it back, and sometimes your bones do get broken, like this one already was broken, so all you're going to do is try to find the joint, and then take it off, put it there. Now, right here, who knows about the wishbone? Well, also the chicken. All fowls have wishbones. Actually, we call them something else. Anyway, there's a wishbone here, which you usually want to take out, but it's not. You can take it out later. It's not particularly necessary. But we'll do it. I'll show you. Just okay. There it is. Okay. So it's right here. There. It's going to be on each side right here. Oh, this one broke. So you can, if it broke, just take it out. But you do want to take everything out. So there it is. You can feel it. It's a little teeny tiny bone as you can see. It's not a big bone. And you're just going to slip your knife there. Just flush and then you'll feel it. Now, when it comes out, it should look, the end should look like this, okay, and then there's the part in the middle. It's giving me some difficulty. Okay, and that's the middle part, which is right here between the two breasts. It would be what we call our breastplate.
So, Chef Ann, are the students doing this as you're doing it?
No, they're going to watch me and then they're going to do it.
So you can do the demo first.
Right. So, the next thing is turn your chicken over, put on some paper, slip all over the place, and you're going to just cut down here, okay? Right down the middle. So, but we're roasting this one, so what do you want me to do?
Well, you're fabricating a chicken by taking it apart, right?
Yes.
Okay. So could you have one more chicken?
I do have one more.
Is it good?
Well, I hope so.
Because that's the one you're going to roast, right?
Yes.
You want to check it first?
Yeah, I'm going to check it.
All right, camera off.
Okay, so this one we're going to roast. So basically, we're going to use our mise en place of the fresh thyme. Oh, also, whenever you describe something, always describe it if it's fresh or if it's dry. So here we have fresh garlic, 6 cloves of fresh garlic. Then you put it in. Fresh thyme, put it in. And if you be so kind and open, it's coarse salt. I use coarse salt instead of fine salt.
Well, would that be the same as kosher salt?
No, I do not use kosher salt.
It's coarse salt.
If you can pour some in there.
Bigger crystals?
It's coarse sea salt. Okay.
So, of course, in a roast chicken, you're not taking off the wingtips, or are you?
Roasted, yes. I do take the wingtips.
But you won't take off.
It's just, I just don't like them. I just think aesthetically.
But I think in the class, you might want to show them to bend the wingtips in. When you're
roasting.
You know what I mean? As it's kind of the more traditional.
Okay.
You'll see that in more of the videos.
We can do that.
You know,
okay.
And of course, you're going to leave the wishbone in.
And I need a little bit of parsley, please, about this much. And just pull it out. Parsley gives a taste, but it also, and you can also put a little bit of onion if you want. It's really up to you. This just kind of keeps everything in. I usually put lemon in it, but I didn't bring lemon this time, so we'll just do it this way. Another thing you can do is if you can grab a couple sprigs of the thyme there, and just set them down here. I'll show you another thing you can do. There are pockets here under the skin. So with two fingers, you just put it underneath like that. And you can put slivers of garlic if you want. What we'll do is we'll just put some thyme.
Now when I do turkey, I just put butter under the skin.
Yeah, we put the butter as well. And this actually, if you fix it really nicely, actually pretty nice looking. You know, just put little sprigs here and there. We'll just put the whole thing right here. Okay? And it gives it taste.
So, Chef Ann, are you going to demonstrate tied or untied?
Untied.
Yeah.
First of all, when you tie it, it's going to take longer. The other thing, the reason I do not like to tie it, and I know Dumbledore would probably have my head off, but this way I find that the breast meat stays a lot. It's not as dry. And it cooks better because this is separate. It's not, you know, it's instead of being a whole bulky thing, it's separate, and so it's going to cook faster. Now you can put some in the legs because basically. And you can actually completely, and I'll show you how to do it, completely debone and make a whole chicken skinless without ever cutting the skin. So we're going to put a little bit here in the legs to give it a little taste. It's going to have taste from the inside as well. But this gives it a little taste, a little extra. And as I said, you can put it on here. Okay. All right, you are going to put a little bit of, you can use anything from olive oil to bacon fat to duck fat, any kind of fat. And Chef Bill, actually, I'm going to ask you if you can open the mobile, please.
Oh, your assistant,
right? Anatomy. Yeah. If you can open the oil. And so the skin ripped here. So usually, afterwards, if you can give me a toothpick, if you can give me the toothpick now, we're going to sew this with toothpicks.
If you can bring that chicken around to your side,
sure,
so we can see it.
Okay.
Natalie, go to the other side.
I'm sorry.
Okay. So you're gonna do it through here.
Sunflower oil versus olive oil?
It
doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. I just use this a little more.
Vegetable oil?
I like to use either that or olive oil. You can also use butter if you want extra.
And
but if you do, I usually use it.
So
it can burn.
So the oil will help seal in the flavor, make it a little bit crispy.
There you go.
Make it brown.
Exactly. Okay, so there's your chicken. Now you're going to take some fine salt, or you can use the coarse salt, and just sprinkle high. If not, I'm going to let you do it.
For the purpose of the class, we might use kosher salt. Is that okay? Because it's a...
I have a,
then it'll rain sprinkle on the meat. Okay. No, just on the chicken.
Just on
it.
Don't need to put it on the vegetables.
Where would you find coarse salt in the common supermarket?
Oh, you can find coarse sea salt.
Coarse sea salt?
Yeah. 99 cents. I bought it. It comes from Italy. That's great.
But kosher salt is not something you would use? So that'll be personal preference then.
It's not as tasty.
Okay.
I find.
All
it's
right.
Personal choice. I've always used sea salt, even when I was in school, I was bringing my own.
Alright.
Okay, so we're basically ready to go. It's oven's been put at 375. We're gonna put it in.
No pepper?
No, we do not go for pepper. We don't have black pepper.
I mean, I have black pepper.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay, a little black pepper.
Okay, camera off now.
Pepper. This is easier to see because it's black, so it's a little better. But you can use a lot of different herbs and spices. Cumin is really tasty. Cumin and lemon is delicious. You can use, of course, paprika, garam masala. There are chili mixes. You can use sumac, which is very good and very tasty. Fennel, even though most of the time it's used for fish, it's very good also with the chicken.
Show us your spice boxes.
So here are my spice boxes. And I put spices on one side and then the dry herbs on the other. Oh, and I forgot. Here, if you could throw that. Yeah. Just crunch it. We're gonna put it in the milk solution infusion. So I use these little boxes. I'm a traveling chef, so I have little boxes with all my herbs and spices. And also, another thing that you don't see very often, which is called essence. Now, what essence is, for example, this is essence of portobello mushroom. And what it is dried portobello mushroom, which I've done in a dehydrator, and then I put it through a coffee grinder, and that pulverizes it, and I use it for sauces, basically sauces, give taste. You can also put this in, when you're making stock, you can also put mushrooms in it. It gives a umami flavor. It's very good. Okay, we have a little bit of lime zest here. Actually, we have lemon zest here. This is lemon skin that I've dehydrated, and I just put a little bit on top. If the pith is very bitter, this is very fragrant, so it'll give a nice little smell. Okay, and taste. So there we have it. So our chicken is good to go.
What temperature is the oven?
It's at 375. We preheated it before starting, and now we're going to put it in. And we're going to cook it for about a half an hour. And then we're going to turn around, because ovens, even though they are, you know, supposed to cook evenly, sometimes they don't. Depends on the oven, so you should always take that into consideration.
So, should Natalie put on her timer?
Okay. Please tell me it's not 5:22.
No.
Okay, now we have the leftover from the giblets. Now, you can do a lot of things with the giblets. You can put them saute them. And or you can put them in your when you're roasting your bones, you can use that as well, but not the liver, just the gizzards. And or you can the French eat the gizzards. These are the gizzards, and they make them confit, which means that they are cooked in fat. But amazingly, when you eat them, they're not greasy at all. It's just like if you were boiling them in water, do it in fat. So this is the liver, and it usually has a little bit of fat. You want to take that out, and it sometimes has a green, like a little green ball. That's the bile. You do not want to cook that. You want to take it out, and you do not want to perforate it. If it gets on the liver or on anything else, it makes it very, very, very bitter. And you do not want that. So, and then this is the heart. A little heart. Okay. You make anticuchos. Look at this. So, there's no bile that I can see. Or if you have a cat or a dog, you can cook it. Give it to my mom. I love liver. You can make sauteed liver with butter, garlic, and parsley. Saute it very quickly, a little salt and pepper, and maybe throw in a little bit of a dash of white wine. It's delicious, and you put it on top of a salad. It's very, very good. All right, so here's our chicken, which has a lot of juice. So maybe this is going to go relatively fast. And I'm going to separate, wipe our chicken down. Have you ever seen the Saturday Night Live, Julia Child?
I think I missed
chicken. Watch it, it's really funny.
All right.
I think Dan Aykroyd.
Well, you're on.
Okay, so here's our chicken, whole chicken, the wings, which are dark meat, oops, right here, the legs, dark meat, and the breast is the white meat. Now, the way the chicken, most people think that the chicken walks like this, but it doesn't actually, it walks this way. The legs are down, here are the wings, neck is here, no tail. So the reason you want to know the anatomy of your animal is because when you're going to make different kinds of recipes, especially for example if you're stuffing, you really need to know how your animal moves, and also it depends on the recipe. For example, if you have a leg quarter, which would be this, which we're going to cut, this big quarter, so it's going to have the thigh and the leg. And then what you can do with that is you can bone it, and stuff it, and roast it, and it's delicious. Same thing with the breast. You take it, you keep the skin, wrap it nicely around, you can stuff the breast meat with, you know, liver. You saute it a little bit, you know, a little garlic, parsley, butter, salt and pepper, little herbs, put it in between, fold it over, wrap it with the skin. The skin basically is used to keep everything together, okay? So, in the middle right here, which is right under the neck bone, but right above it, you'll feel a bone, and it's the wishbone. So it's right, it's a little bone. Just give a little incision there, feel it better. Actually, you know what's really funny is that these are really, really tiny, where the ones usually that I, the other chickens I use, they're a lot bigger. I can feel them right away. It's really good.
Would it be easier if you did the wishbone later? Take it out later?
No, it's got to be done now. So, there, so I found it. So all you're going to do is flip it like that. Or just make a little incision, then with your fingers you can just feel it and just pull it out. Remember, you have the part in the middle too. And there we go. There you have your wish, half of the wishbone. You need to find the other part. Okay. And there's the other part. Have your wishbone, keep it, you don't need to throw it out. And then for the wings, I forgot how to do it. I haven't done it in years. But anyway, for the wings, take off the wings, the tuck, right? I forgot how you tuck it.
Oh, when you're roasting a chicken?
Yeah. Bones are going to come out clean with no cartilage on it. Okay, you're just going to cut that one. Clean cut. Same thing over here. Pull it back. Here's the bone and cut. All right. And your chicken is ready to get roasted. Okay. You want to stuff it with anything. Herbs, or if you have some rice that you want to put in, or anything like that, then this is the time to do it, okay? You're going to season your salt inside. If you're not going to stuff it, season salt, pepper, herbs, garlic, whatever you want. Put hopperdosh, it depends on your recipe, okay?
I'm around.
You have the tail, and you have the neck, okay? This this is how the chicken is formed. So this is the spinal cord. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take everything off so you can see the anatomy of the chicken. So straight down from neck all the way down to the tail. Okay? So you have the skin here, right? So you're going to, anywhere you can find where it's a little loose, and you have, you can actually even do it with your hand. Slide it under. If you have any difficulties, for example, it starts tearing, or you have some parts that can be difficult, with the tip of your knife, just the tip, you don't make these big incisions, it's just the tip of your knife. Okay. So here, I'm going to cut this off so you can see the anatomy of the chicken. So here are the tendons that are holding up the leg. This is your leg quarter. So basically, you can take and skin a whole chicken, keep it, debone the chicken meat, and then you can put it back in, and that would be a galantine or a balantine, depending. Galantine is hot. I'm sorry, galantine is cold, balantine is hot. But it's basically the meat that's restuffed in the skin. Okay, I'm almost there. So I just wanted to show you the anatomy of the chicken. It's important to know it. You can see the muscles here. Okay, so this is the thigh, the leg. And it's actually, so here you see it's detached. Okay, what you're gonna do is just with the knife, there's a bone there, but you're gonna pull it back like this. And you're just going to follow. See? This is why it's important to know the anatomy. If you know your chicken or any other, you know, animal, then you're going to know where to cut and the easiest way to cut so that you don't have to, you know, battle with it. So here you have the joint and you just pull, go around. There are some tendons there.
So you can, if you were deboning the whole
chicken and skinning it, you can actually do the whole skin. It's a little more complicated. This would be like the haute couture of cooking. It's high culinary. So we're just going to do the simple stuff today. But it's important to know that you have this option so that when you see, you know, at the supermarket, skinless, boneless, you know what it is.
Yeah.
Okay? To know your meat. So to debone, if you want to come closer here, I'll show you. So you have the bone here of the leg. You have here the bone of the thigh. I'm just going to run it against the thigh bone like that. And just the tip, you don't need a fillet knife. I find these to be a lot better than the fillet knife. And then you just want to take out the bone and the cartilage over here. And all you do is attach that. It's going to be real easy. You just even slip the knife like that. Hold both bones, pull it back. Sometimes it works really well, and sometimes not so well.
Now, in Rack of Lamb, there's a term called Frenching.
Frenching is, yes, that's when you take the bone, and there are a lot of bones on the Rack of Lamb like this. So what you're doing is, if this is the meaty part of the lamb, my palm, you're basically taking all the skin and the tendons that are between the bones all the way down to the meat. So you're clearing up. But when you do that, you then have to cover those bones, because when you put them in the oven, they burn very easily. So it's a good thing. It's a better thing. So same thing here. It's almost as thin as a toothpick. So here you got it out. Bone is out, main bone is out, but the cartilage is still in there, and so is this toothpick bone. This is the toothpick bone. Okay. And this is the actual leg bone with the cartilage at the end. So now you just want to, this is the thigh bone. And then here you have the cartilage, which you also need to take out. Have a little piece left, so it's not very pleasant. for the tooth. Okay, and then this extra fat you can take off. So now you have basically a whole leg that you can stuff. Like that. Okay, you stuff it, roll it, stick it back in the case of the leg. Sew it up with some toothpicks and then you're good to go. Okay, we need
Delica.
I need another cutting board. Just give me the cutting board that's over there. And I need a pot. If you could give me actually the skillet over here. your tenderloin. Now the tenderloin has also here a tendon, and you don't want that when you're cooking them. So same thing, your knife is just gonna slide against it. If it's too slippery, use paper. But just slide. Taking the, this is called the carcass at this point. today, or almost months. Harvest with the old ones. Okay. You just want to attach this, which is the this part, and you're going to leave it on the attached to the breast. Why you want to be careful. There are a lot of little bones, hence why you don't give those to dogs, because they could perforate your stomach. So you can put the fire on. You can either roast them or put them on the fire. The huge fact of the oven is what it is. We're going to roast, we're going to put them on the fire at a medium low. Okay. Where's my screw? Somewhere. Oh, thank you. Thank you. All right.
That's we call that sometimes a bench scraper.
It's called actually. It's for. It's really done for pastry.
So this is a.
And it's to cut. You know. When you're making bread, you cut it, or scrape it when you flip it over and things like that.
So the bench scraper is the, what, the plastic one, or?
Yeah, I believe so. So, okay, so you have all the skin, right, here. If you were deboning all your meat, or you can take, for example, you can leave these guys on, take out, debone that, put this breast back in, stuff it. You're going to have to take a little bit out. And then you bake it with stuff in it, or, you know, or just like that. You don't have to automatically stuff it. So here you have your leg quarter, okay, that still has the skin, right? Here you have your breast that still has the weight. You would take this off if you were cooking it with a little wing. Same thing, always look, you know, where you're, just feel it once to see where it is. Notice I didn't leave the joint in. So when you have just, you have a recipe where you cook the whole breast, okay? And you keep a little part of the wing on. It usually has a little paper decoration. Anyway, so this is your leg quarter, and this is your breast. Now,
just want to do with these.
Okay, so dark meat versus white meat. This is a preference, but it's also a way of cooking chicken that's different. If you overcook white meat, it is going to be very, very dry, okay, and not very tasty. You better have a nice sauce on it. You can do with the breast meat, just the white meat, you can stuff it, okay, and then cook it, bake it, or, you know, put it in the pan, finish it off in the oven, any way you like. This depends on your recipe. The best thing to do with white meat is to sear it. When you sear it, what happens is that all the juices are locked in. So your chicken, by the way, don't sear it when it's frozen, the white meat, because it'll tend to become very rubbery, so you don't want to do that. But you sear it, and then you finish it off in the oven, and it's very, very tasty and moist. Same thing with the leg quarter, which is the leg as well as the thigh. So this is what it would look like. It would be deboned, and you would put toothpicks in it. You know, stuff it, debone it, stuff it where the bone was, and just reshape it like a wolf for a leg. I also tend to stick the leg back in sometimes, because then you can make different shapes. You can play around with it, okay? So I'm gonna undo. Once again, short little cuts. Move them around and see how it's going to there. That is what's going to make that thin glass, okay?
And it's DEMIGLACE, I think.
Correct.
Demi glass.
And with the demi, is it DEMI? And then a little
glass. Oh, hyphen.
I don't know.
Hyphen, right?
Glass. Yeah. But this, that A has a little cap on it, actually, that might be really good. Okay, oh, this weekend should allow. Are we still on, Bill?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right, so this is going. Okay. This is just going to get brown. We're going to toss them. Don't need to put anything in.
Okay.
Okay, nothing at all. What we did forget to do, however, was the potatoes. So we're going to have to do potatoes real fast. Either that or I may saute potatoes. Peel some potatoes.
Peel some potatoes? Okay.
Yeah, real fast. I can peel some potatoes, throw them in there.
You need my peeler, right?
Oh, and I've washed the potatoes here. Oh, there. I only have one eye, so I don't see very well.
Versus
here, you're gonna look at the where the way the meat is going, you know, the fibers. So this one's going that way, this one's going this way. So it's on this side, you can't really see. Okay, so we're gonna do that. You're gonna cut it this way. Still not hot enough. You want it to be really hot. Okay? Wait a little more. board, you don't have to sit on high seat, you sit on medium seat, you're fine. So white meat and dark meat, it's a preference, example, I like both, but I prefer dark meat, I just find it a little tastier.
Yes, there.
Okay.
Next up.
Oh, great. Okay. One. we're going to add a little butter instead of the oil. Now, in order for your butter not to burn, usually what you do is you add a tad of oil that tempers it, just like chocolate tempers the butter. we're not going to, no, we're just going to. For the lesson, I'll do it. Not knowing this oven, you know, the, I don't like the way the chicken came out, it's not right. Okay. Here. We do have other gloves. Oh,
yes.
I have some, but wait, no, I still have some. I still have some. All right, so. Encase that. You'll see that it's, you can do it. States. If you're going to mix sauces, it's going to cook the sauce. It's going to keep it in shape. It's not going to go, you know, so first of all, it's easier to cut when it's raw than when it's cooked. And when it cooks, it just sears everything. And so it stays juicy.
Yeah.
And it holds its shape. Brown now. Garlic, and another board here. Where did it go?
Oh, put it in chicken.
Oh, that's right. I have another one.
I have a board.
Okay. So here you go. Here, 2 cloves of garlic and ice corn here. There we go. 2 nice cloves of garlic. Okay, let's not forget this garlic. I'm getting good old things. Put it on the side here, they're browner anyway.
Yeah.
Then you have the dark meat, you'll see how different it is. And then at this point, you can do the oven thing by just covering it if you want.
For the garnish, you want me to just peel them?
Peel them, and then we're going to slice them. In order to get the most out of your garlic, I don't know if you know, oh, so you have to pull that off. Okay. And then to get the most, you don't cut them this way, you cut them this way, because that's where all the garlic oil will come out. Okay. And the reason I'm making them big is because you don't want to have them, unless you're really crazy about garlic, and then in that case, you know, you get this stuff. Chomp on it, but
it's like a flavor, not so vegan.
I love garlic too. The other day I made a very, very garlicky pizza. It came out fantastic.
Okay. My mom plants her garlic and it's really dark.
So see, it came out with juice.
Yeah.
Okay. So the way nice and juicy. I usually just touch the chicken and just put it in the chicken, of course, for my dog.
Oh,
it's a lot better.
Yes.
For them, I make rice and I make chicken for them.
Blend. Just blend, right?
Yeah, with carrots and green beans and sweet potatoes, yams, I mean it depends, whatever's on sale, you know, throw in there. And I make those baked, actually. Okay, so what you're going to do is, basically you want to see that they're just like that. Oh, we didn't put salt in there. Right?
Yes.
And we cooked. Okay, so these guys, sauce. Strain the potatoes. When you wear glasses, they get steamed up. Okay. Okay. Now over here, we're going to do is take, so we infuse the thyme. So you just take these little guys out. If you don't score, you can put them in a stock. There's very little one has to grow up. So the big branches, we're just going to take like that. The potatoes are basically good to go. This goes back in. The little pine leaves are fine. Actually, this is a nice taste. Then what we're going to do, even though this should have been heated and infused and so on and so on, we're just going to throw it in. Going to keep it. Why are we going to keep it? Because we didn't infuse it and heat it up, so we can use it again. Stick it back in the fridge. We're going to heat it up. Some more milk, or half and half, or whatever it is you want to use. One thing with strainers, you're going to put them right away, because otherwise they're a pain in the neck to clean. Butter, and I like to put some pieces of butter like that instead of one blob, because then it melts faster. So that's So maybe they have some. Well, bad. They don't. They don't. Okay. Okay, I'm going to carve the chicken. Okay, so get all the sauce. These carrots, you can actually, if you have a pan, we just have the chicken stuff, so it's the same thing. You can throw those in. Saute them real quickly. Okay. These guys. Wow. So the good thing about it is usually it sticks together. You know, it fuses together. And now you can cut. Why don't you ask Chef Bill if you want white meat or dark meat or a little bit of both?
Okay.
Please, thank you. Talking about the garlic is that it gets, so basically what you have is roasted garlic. And all you do is peel and get that garlic out. Otherwise, here, let's put that on. Let's get it roast sauteed. Because we'll mix those with the green beans and it'll be nice and colorful and pretty and be nice and tasty. And especially so there you have. So let's cut these little guys off. And okay, see the caramelization of the onion? That gives taste. And color, taste and color. So there's one. Oh, there we go. There it is.
Watch your knife. Very good. So,
oyster?
No, I just have some press.
Hmm?
I just have some press.
It's not the oyster here. Okay, same thing with a little wing. Yeah, just follow it around. You don't want to cut too much of the breast meat, okay? So, and then just okay. Same thing on the other side. Red like that, it doesn't mean that it's not cooked. It's just because it's close to the bone. That's why we insert it right there in the armpit. Okay. So, same thing. Now that it's cooked, that bone hasn't changed, but you're going to have to separate them. Okay? So, this is what you want to do, that we have the bone. You have the separation of the... How big do you want it?
Medium.
No, I mean the whole thing?
No.
No?
Just,
okay.
Just a couple of pieces.
Okay. Now this is cooked, so it's obviously going to separate very easily from the tender one. Okay, because each muscle is covered by a very, very thin membrane. Okay, that keeps them, so when they're cooked, very easy to separate. Okay, now what you want to do so that your skin is nice and shiny, you want to, you know, bathe it in this juice. Also, in the other side, so it's nice and juicy. And another plate, yes, please. Now, at this point in time, you can take the time out if you want. You want me to take the time out, Bill?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So you take the time out. At least you can leave the leaves, just the branches you take out. Okay. And I should have brought some real plates, but anyway. If you want light meat too. Or if you want dark meat.
What?
Okay. Okay, so same thing here. See how here you go. Here you see this?
Yes.
Fine. So, is this big enough or?
It's too big.
Too big? You want half?
Yeah. I'll share with that.
Okay. So you can always cut it on the thighs. And slowly serve. So now you have the tenderloin back here and part of the breast meat, okay? So what you're going to do is you take all the meat off that you can use for doing sandwiches or, you know, whatever you want to do. And then you keep the bones, brown them in the oven, brown them in here as you like, and there you have it.
Voila.
So some potatoes. We'll do another time. We'll do complaining. I think everybody's hungry and tired. Oh, anyway, okay, I'll take that one. I have no fear of my toes anymore. Thank you. All right, and we can put some beans. Let's heat up the beans just in case. Yeah, there. Let's heat them up real, real quick. So with the, as I said, you can either put it inside or you can, you know, the garlic, or you can put it inside the sauce on the chicken. Okay, if anybody wants any more of this, we cover up the nut and stick it in the fridge. I'll take it home. Let's see, what else? I'm just gonna soak all of this so that it's good to go. Gonna be lost.
Bill.
All right. You got three plates we can take a picture?
Yes, we can. They're not the best looking plates in the world, but...
All right.
Do you like gravy on your potatoes?
Just a little bit. Picture of all the hard work. Your neighbors.